And salutations to each one of you who is watching this video. Today I wanted to start the conversation on boundaries. I will also be posting a guided imagery, a guided meditation that will help you engage with it on a more felt sense basis, and you could even do art at the end of it. But before that, I wanted to open up the conversation of boundaries. I think what even to begin to think about this work of boundaries was a huge breakthrough for myself, and it happened after I heard this talk by Brené Brown, which I have actually shared with you on the email, where she says that the most compassionate people are the most boundary. And she speaks about how important it is for us to have boundaries. And you will see that when you trace your body map, when you just even begin by drawing the outline of your body map on a surface, and when you look at it, you will see that there is a boundary to our body. To this body, there is a boundary, right? Our spirit is endless. Our spirit is infinite. It has no boundaries, right? It is huge, expansive at the same time, when as that spirit being in this body, right, we have a boundary. And this dance of having no boundary and yet setting boundaries is the dance of living our life. And what do boundaries really mean? I feel boundaries are something that should free us, that just should give us freedom of exploration, freedom of expression, freedom of engagement. At the same time, holding space for whatever is showing up for us and others, right? So boundaries are very important. So this is not just that boundary which binds us, which boxes us, which chains us, which restricts us, limits us, but this is a boundary which frees us. And what do you mean? What do we mean by that? What do I mean by that? This whole journey of the Shakti woman is actually the journey of becoming who you are, becoming, reclaiming, stepping into your authentic self and living, interacting, exploring, engaging, embodying in this world from your authentic self. And that requires deep courage and deep vulnerability. If you're not willing to be vulnerable, then it is very difficult to really step into your authentic self or even be the Shakti woman. And when we speak about vulnerability, and vulnerability has a lot to do with our heart and not the head, right? The heart needs to be protected. The heart needs to be protected at all costs, at all times. And that is why we need boundaries, so that we can hold space around our heart, protect our heart, at the same time be free, whole, and engage in life fearlessly and freely. And boundaries, usually when I say boundaries, I actually mean boundary with respect to the other, right? With the respect to the other boundary, because boundary is only between bodies, right? So there is a boundary, and honoring that boundary, not just for yourself, but also for the other, right? Even if the other knows about it or not, even if the other acknowledges it or not, there is a boundary. And when we know about boundaries, we honor that. Usually what happens is we create a lot of boundaries in our relationship with our own self, and we become very free with everyone around us, all the bodies, objects, people, situations, things. We are free. We want to be free. We want to have no boundaries. Yet with our own self, we have so many boundaries. We restrict our own self in so many different ways, not looking at, or not able to face ourselves in the mirror, right? So when we talk about sacred boundaries, it's reversing. Having no boundaries with your own self, being free, naked, raw, in front of yourself, being naked in the mirror, seeing yourself fully, all aspects, all shades, all polarities, light, shadow, dark, seeing yourself fully, but honoring boundaries with others, yeah? Developing boundaries with others. And it is very, very important to be free, that we recognize boundaries, that there are boundaries. You may feel very close, intimately close to somebody. It could be your partner, life partner, or it could be a friend, it could be your mother, it could be your child. And you feel there are no boundaries physically, right? We create no boundaries, and we want to be fully vulnerable and fully be available to them. And at the same time, one fine day something happens and there is deep hurt that happens. And we feel that that person changed, that person is something different, but that person has always been that, right? We have not really honored our own boundaries and not honored their boundaries, right? So to face ourselves in the mirror is a big task enough. You know, it's a task big enough. And we need to let others face their own mirrors and don't grab and look into their mirror. Let them have their mirror, let them deal with it, that is their journey. And so honoring boundaries, whatever the relationship may be, I learned it the hard way in my life that there are boundaries. As much as I don't want to accept it, I don't want boundaries, I want to be free, I want you to love me without any boundaries. Yes, at the level of the spirit, there are no boundaries, but at the level of the body, there are boundaries, right? And we have to honor them. And that helps us to be 100% in any relationship, give our full to any relationship, and yet acknowledge the boundary. So what does that mean? So where are boundaries? So boundaries are definitely there with our body, in our emotional space, again with respect to the other, right? There is boundary, there are boundaries, there is intellectually, there are boundaries, right? Honoring the boundary of another person with respect to their own intellect, right? And it's very important. And so first is to even recognize that there are boundaries. And not, usually when we realize that there are boundaries is when we have already been deeply hurt by the other, or we have let ourselves, actually the other really doesn't hurt, other is just voicing the violation of their boundaries. They themselves may not have any idea about it. But we feel hurt, right? Because our boundaries at those moments get compromised. And usually when we have no boundaries, we realize boundaries only when it has become already too late. There's been deep hurt caused, and that whole relationship just goes out of the window, and it goes, sometimes it becomes irreparable. So boundaries help us recognize there is a separation. Right? And that's why we have the ego, because ego does bring that separation. We are separate, at the same time we are one. So we are always in that dichotomy of the two, and that's the sacred masculine. Sacred masculine is about boundaries, right? The feminine, the sacred feminine is about the oneness, about us being ancient, together. You're mine, I'm yours. That knowing in the spirit, in the space. And yet sacred masculine is about honoring this body, this separation, this uniqueness that I have, that you have, and I honor that. Acknowledging and recognizing boundaries is a very, very important thing.